You're thinking about getting Luminar Neo, or you did already and you're thinking about jumping right in and start working on your images to bring them to the next level. Awesome. My name is Philip from letsimage.com, and in this video we will run over everything that you need to know about Luminar Neo to do exactly that. We'll focus on layout first, then functions, and of course also have an example that we take with us through the ride, so to speak. After this, you can jump right in. If you like Luminar, I'll tell you how to save some money at the end of the video. Let's start. There are three important areas within Luminar Neo that you can switch to whenever you like. The catalog, the preset area, and the editing area. And there's also a secret area that you have to unlock by being a subscriber to this channel and hitting the thumbs up button on this video. Spoilers, that may be a lie, but let's do it anyway, just in case. Now, starting at the catalog, you can add your photos, which will sort them into the respective categories on the left-hand side here. Whatever images you do add to Luminar, they will show up in the center area of the screen. On the top here, you can adjust which photos to see and how small or large you'd like to see them in the grid. On the lower left side, you can add a folder or create an album. A folder is an actual folder that you have on your computer. So if you would have a folder on your desktop called My Most Amazing Images or Need to Edit This, and you add that folder to Luminar, then the folders would show up here and the images within it would show up in Luminar itself. An album in Luminar is different, as it's just a collection of photos for organizational purposes. A use case would be if you have two folders for two different photo shoots you did, but you want to pull out all the portrait photos that you might want to edit. You could do that by adding them into an album without affecting the location on the computer. On the right-hand side, you have Luminar Neo's extras, which is what they call their extensions. You can use them to create high dynamic range photos from bracketed photos, load pictures in for focus stacking, or upscale photos to increase resolution. You don't have to get these extensions, but you can by clicking on the top on extras. Now we have an understanding of the general layout, so let's load an image in. Hit Add Photos and select. Once you edit your images in, you can reject them for easier deletion later, or mark them as favorites by clicking the heart or hitting P. You can then show only your favorites by selecting them either on the top or the left-hand side category. Double-click on an image or hit the space key to enlarge the photo. Now, with my image selected, let's move on to the preset section. The image will enlarge and you can now select the preset. If you're new, a preset is a set of adjustments that will automatically be applied to your image with one click, like a template. And it'll therefore quickly transform your photo depending on what that particular preset does. On the top right, Luminar Neo will suggest some preset categories for your selected photo. You can also scroll down to see more categories, or see them all at the bottom right here. You can click on a preset category to show all the presets within it. Selecting one will then apply the adjustments within it to your photo. To see the before and after, select the eye symbol down here, and to revert to the original, select the arrow next to the preset you selected. You can favorite a preset for future use by selecting the heart, and find it next time by selecting favorites in the usual preset screen. Now say we don't want to use a preset and let's move on to the editing section. Layers here allow you to add, well, layers. You can click the plus icon and either add your own images or choose from things like light leaks, flares, bokeh, and so on. On the right, you have all your tools, categorized by more extensions, essentials, creative, portrait, and professional adjustments. Selecting an adjustment will open its settings. The essentials category contains things like the develop module, which is usually a great start to any edit, because here you can adjust brightness and colors. Now note, if I click the header of the adjustment again, it'll close and move over to the top right here under edits. Any edit you make will show up here, so you can go back later and change things if you need to. Now to name a few more, essential adjustments also contain things like noise removal, vignetting, golden hour color edition, and so on. The creative category lets you add things like sun rays, change skies, LUTs to adapt the color, fog, or create a glow as needed to soften things up a bit. The portrait section lets you enhance bokehs, adapt face and body if you so desire, and use the popular high key editing. And lastly, you have the professional section with things like the clone stamp tool, color harmony, and dodge and burn. I will make a video about all these tools soon, but for now it should give you enough information to get going and simply try them out. That's the best way of learning about the tools and what they do by just moving the sliders. Talking about sliders, most adjustments have simple sliders like this. And once you change something, you'll find the option to hide the adjustment and to revert it on the top right of it. You can also choose from a variety of masking options to ensure your adjustment only shows up where you want to. Cool enough, there is an AI tool here that helps you create the mask you need. With it, you can select different elements in your image automatically. If you prefer manual work, of course you can choose to brush your mask in, use a gradient, a radial mask, and more. Mask Actions allows you to show your mask, revert it, fill it, or copy and paste it. Now, if you find yourself using the same adjustments again and again, you can right-click on them and keep them as a favorite, in which case they'll show up at the top of your adjustments list. Now, this is the image we imported earlier, so let's go through an example edit. I'll start using the Develop module and add a bit of contrast. Bring down the highlights and open up the shadows. Next, let's bring up the whites and down the blacks. The image overall is a bit yellow, so let's change the temperature towards a bit more blue. Let's bump up our saturation and also the vibrance a bit. Damn! Look at what we just done with one adjustment module. Look at the beautiful light on the rocks here and the textures. Talking about textures, let's select structure and bump that up. Look at that, I love it. Now I only want it in the rocks, so let's select masking, brush and brush the structure enhancements into the mountains. Next, let's jump to colors, increase the blue and orange saturation a bit. And now to really give it some awesomeness, let's head down to super contrast, increase the shadow contrast and change the shadow balance to the right. To guide the eye of the viewer a bit more, let's create another development adjustment and bring down the exposure and use a gradient to add the change into the foreground. Lastly, let's go to crop and give it a nice wide cinematic crop. Now look at that before and after. One looks like you found it in a newspaper from the 70s, the other one looks like you want to print it and hang it over your bed because you want it to be the last thing you see every time before you go to bed. Now, if you want to save some money on Luminar Neo, you can use the link in the description as well as the promotional code LETSIMAGE to save $10 or euros or whatever your currency might be on your purchase. That will also support the channel, so thank you to all of you that do. Note, there are also some things that I don't like about Luminar Neo, and I'll put them somewhere in a video that is linked somewhere on the screen right now. Now, time for you to dive in. As always, stay safe and I shall see you next time. Bye!